Hello friends, welcome back to Sabir CAD. Hope you have got some systematic and useful information about the basics of AutoCAD software. I'm sure that if you had gone through those basic video tutorials on AutoCAD, by now you will definitely be in a position to create two-dimensional drawings on your own, be it mechanical, civil, architectural, or electrical. This video primarily deals with creating two-dimensional mechanical drawings. I have explained the procedure to create civil site plan and floor plan. Please find the links at the upper right corner of this video as well as at the description section. I have provided link to download the electrical drawing at the description section of this video. You can download that particular drawing and you can try it on your own using the same drawing and editing commands in AutoCAD. But that's not all. There are many other concepts in AutoCAD, the knowledge of which will make you more productive, such as complex objects, layers, blocks and attributes, annotations, tables, grips and arrays, isometric drafting, plotting techniques, etc. You can also explore the world of 3D in AutoCAD. You can create any real world object in AutoCAD 3D using various 3D modeling commands, view, present and plot that model from any desired angle. I teach all these things and more online. Please find the link at the upper right corner of this video as well as at the description section. Before exploring the topic, I request all of you to subscribe to my YouTube channel Sabir CAD if you haven't subscribed already and hit the bell icon to get instant updates on my future video uploads. Thank you. Let's continue with the topic on basic editing commands in AutoCAD. In this tutorial, you will learn the applications of erase, trim, fillet, offset, and mirror commands in AutoCAD. Let's create this figure using the drawing and editing commands we have already learned. When you look at this figure, you can see that it's made up of 5 circles. Center point and radius of each circle is given. This circle is kept in the first quadrant, this one in the second, third and the fourth quadrants. Hence, each circle is kept in each quadrants. If you want to see all the circles properly on the screen, you should set a proper limit. So, how will you set a limit? Here, the lower left corner should be minus minus. Because this circle has got a center point coordinate of minus 35 comma minus 35. So, this particular corner will be at a distance of 35 plus 17.5, which is the radius of the circle, which is 52.5. That means you have to give a value below 52.5 so that this particular circle will be well within the screen. Hence, I'll keep the lower left at minus 60 comma minus 60 and the upper right corner at 60 comma 60, and such a figure can be drawn well within such a screen with these limits. So I'll give a limits command, and when I'm asked to define the lower left, I'll give minus 60 comma minus 60, and when I'm asked to give the upper right, I'll give 60 comma 60. Then I'll give a zoom command followed by all option to bring the limits within the screen. Now let's create circles. So I'll click on circle command, center radius method. When I'm asked to give center, I'll give 0,0 because I'm creating the center circle first. Now it'll ask you for the radius. I'll give 17.5 as the radius. I'll give enter to repeat the circle command. Now I'm asked to give the coordinate of the center point of the next circle. I'll give 35,35. When I'm asked to give radius, I don't have to give any value because the radius of the most recently drawn circle will remain there as default. So I'll give an enter to accept that value. Now I'll give another enter to repeat the circle command, and this circle has got a center point at minus 35,35, and when I'm asked to give radius, I give enter. The center point coordinate of the next circle is at minus 35,-35, which is in the third quadrant, and give an enter to accept the radius. The center point coordinate of the fourth circle is at 35,-35, which is in the fourth quadrant, and just give enter to accept the radius. Hence, we have created all the required circles. Next, we have to connect these circles using arcs. We have already seen that two objects can be connected using a tangent arc using the fillet command. So I'll give fillet command. Here the radius is given as 22. So I'll go to radius and give the value 22. Now I'm asked to select the first object and the second object, and I've got the fillet. Now give enter to repeat the fillet command, first object, second object. Now give one more enter, first object, second object. Again enter, first, second. In fillet, you should always pick outward like this. But when you pick inward, you will get arc in a different direction. So I'll pick outward and I've got the fillet. Now we have to remove portion of circle between arcs. For that, you can make use of the trim command. So I'll click on trim. When you are asked to give cutting edge, you can give an enter, because when you give enter, all the objects will get selected and the cutting edges will also get included in that selection. Now you are asked to select the object to trim. I'll select this one, over here, as well as here. Hence, by using circle, fillet and trim commands, we have completed this figure. You can also make a try so that you will get hands-on experience in applying and practicing these commands. Next, we will try this figure. This figure, as well as the previous figure, is attached below this video. You can keep the cursor on the respective figures, right-click and save the images in JPEG format for easy access. When you look at this figure, you can see that we have a rectangle over here with a dimension of 100 by 85 units. Before I create this rectangle, I'll set a proper limit. So I'll give limits command. I'll give 0,0 as the coordinate of the lower left corner because there is no negative values. And I'll give a value which is above 100 for the upper right corner. So I'll give it as 150,150. Then I'll give a zoom all to bring the limits within the screen. Next, I'll go to rectangle command and I'll pick to define the first corner over here. Then I'll go to dimension option. When I'm asked to give the length, I'll give 85 and width, I'll give 100. I'll pick the opposite corner point over here and I've completed the rectangle. When you click on this rectangle, you can see that it's a single object. Now I'll create arcs at the corners using the fillet. But if you want to fillet all the four corners of such a rectangle, which is a single object, we have a special option in the fillet command. Let's see that. So I'll go to fillet command and I'll click on radius option and I'll give a radius of 10 units. R10 means radius of 10. There is a polyline option in the fillet command. This rectangle can be treated as a polyline because it's a single object. So go to polyline option and click on the rectangle. Now you can see that all the four corners got filleted simultaneously. Next, we have to create the slot. You can see that this slot has got a width of 15 and a depth of 25. So I'll start with a line from this midpoint and I'll keep the cursor straight down. Then I'll type 25 and enter to go out of the line command. Next, I'll go to offset command. When I'm asked to give the offset distance, I'll give half of 15, which is 7.5. Then I'll select object side and object and pick a point on the desired side. Select the center line and erase it since it's no longer required. Now draw a line connecting these two endpoints and hence we have completed the profile for the slot. Next, I'll create the circle. You know that center of the circle is at a distance of 15 units from both these edges. So I'll go for offset and I'll give an offset distance of 15 units. Now I'll select this object to offset. When I'm asked to specify the side to offset, I'll pick a point inside. And this upper right corner is the center of the circle. So I'll go to circle command, choose center radius option. When I'm asked to specify the center point, I'll choose this corner and I'll give the radius as 6 because the diameter is given as 12. I'll erase this object and I'll mirror these two objects onto the bottom side. So I'll click on the mirror command. And I'll select these two objects using a standard window. When I'm asked to specify the first point on the mirror line, I'll pick this midpoint and this mid is the second point. Now I don't want to erase a source object, so I'll give no. Now I've got the mirror image on the screen. Next, I'll create an arc with radius of 21. For that, I'll first draw a circle and trim to make it an arc. So I'll go to circle, center radius, and I'll choose this mid as the center point and I'll give a radius of 21, which is given. Next, I'll create the slot. For that, I'll draw a line with a length of 26. So I'll click on line command, I'll start from this midpoint, I'll turn the ortho mode on and I'll type a distance of 26. Next, I have to give an offset of 9 each to get these two lines. So I'll go to offset command and I'll give an offset distance of 9 units. When I'm asked to select the object to offset, I'll click this line, side to offset, object, side. Next, I'll go to circle command, choose center radius option and I'll keep this endpoint as the center and I'll give a radius of 9 units. I'll erase the center line. Next, I'll perform trim. So I'll click on trim command. When I'm asked to select the cutting edges, I'll give an enter. Now I'm asked to select the object to trim. So I'll click on required objects that are to be trimmed at precise locations. Hence, I have completed this figure. In this tutorial, we have learned applications of erase, trim, fillet, offset, and mirror commands in AutoCAD. In the next tutorial, you will learn the concept and applications of polylines. Hope you have got an idea about how two-dimensional mechanical drawings can be created using AutoCAD software. Please hit the like button of this video if you liked it. Until I catch you in another interesting video with an interesting topic, bye bye and take care. May God bless you all. I once again request you to subscribe to my YouTube channel, SabirCAD, where CAD training is made easy. Also, don't forget to visit sabircad.teachable.com, wherein AutoCAD 2D, 3D is taught from basic to advanced, project based. You can also learn 3D visualization using AutoCAD 3D, 3ds Max, and Adobe Photoshop in this website. Once you enroll the courses, you will get lifetime account. Means there is no deadline or time limit to complete the courses. You will also get all future updates of lessons for free. You can get all your queries answered through WhatsApp chat and mail.